Imagine this. It's almost the end of a long week and you're sitting in the middle of math class, trying desperately to stay awake. It's at this point you hear the teacher say something that catches your attention.
And no matter what, you can't have 0 divided by 0.
You think to yourself, that seems strange. Of course I can divide 0 by 0. I'll simply write it down and see, there you go. 0 divided by 0 is equal to 0. That wasn't so hard. Or did you? After all, just because you can write down an expression, that doesn't make it true. What gives then? Why can't we divide 0 by 0, and what is it actually equal to? To get to the bottom of this answer, it's important to understand exactly where the problem is, and once we do, we might be able to find just enough wiggle room to actually divide by 0. By now you've probably seen many different rules and formulas when learning mathematics, but you may have also noticed that no matter how many new rules you learn, they always seem to fit perfectly with everything that came before it. Algebra, trigonometry, calculus, differential equations, the list of subjects goes on. But at every stage, what you learned previously doesn't change, and it is in fact necessary for understanding what you're doing now. So, no matter what new rule or law you decide to cook up, it's important that it must fit with all of our other previous rules. And therein lies the problem. With our familiar number system, no matter what number we try and assign to dividing a number by 0, there's always another rule that comes along and conflicts with it. Let's give it a try. First, we might simplify the problem a bit by only looking at what happens when we divide non-zero numbers by 0. This is a good place to start, since having 0 in the numerator, or top, is usually not a problem. For example, we could take 0 divided by 5, and the answer is simply 0. So, a huge part of the problem lies with actually trying to divide by 0. In this case, we might attempt to give it a value of, say, 0. So, for 5 divided by 0, we'll just call this 0. But unfortunately, this doesn't work. It doesn't fit with all of our other previous rules. Multiplication and division are opposites. So, in a way, this statement is just another way of saying that 5 is equal to 0 times 0. And that is definitely not true. We have a rule that says multiplication by 0 should be equal to 0. In fact, no matter what value we give a statement like a divided by 0, where a is some non-zero number, it will never be consistent with what we've already established in our multiplication rules. Well, this is certainly a problem with something like 5 divided by 0. But maybe we can find something that works for 0 divided by 0. Maybe in this one case we can let it equal 0. Unfortunately, this still doesn't work. The rule that doesn't fit now is our rule that says any number divided by itself should equal 1. We might try and fix this by letting it equal something else. Maybe we'll say 0 divided by 0 is equal to 1. That way it better fits with all of our other rules. But we just covered that when 0 is divided by a number, it should be equal to 0. So once again, we're left in a situation that no matter what value we give it, it simply will not fit with our other rules. Because of this, we say that we cannot divide 0 by 0, or more mathematically, we say that 0 divided by 0 is left undefined. As you can see, the main issue we keep running into is staying consistent with all of our previous rules we've already agreed upon. But what if we used a different number system and kept our usual operations? Then could we divide by 0? The surprising and wonderful answer is yes, absolutely. Take, for example, the real number line. Here we can represent all of the numbers we are familiar with. Now let's make a small change by adding a point, which we'll represent using the infinity symbol. This point will exist above all of the real numbers and also below all of the real numbers. A good way to visualize where this new point is located is to bend our real number line so that it now connects in a circle at this new point. As a fun fact, this is called a one-point compactification of the real line. Under this new structure, we can still add, subtract, or multiply the usual numbers. But we must also assign meaning when using these operations with our brand new point. So let's do just that. Let's say that a non-zero number, when divided by 0, is called infinity. Under this new system, 5 divided by 0 is equal to infinity. But what about the corresponding multiplication problem? Do we still have issues with that? In a way, we do. Since 5 divided by 0 is equal to infinity, and negative 7 divided by 0 is also equal to infinity under our system, it's unclear what we should call the opposite problem involving multiplication. Should it be 5? Should it be negative 7? What do we do when 0 is multiplied by infinity? It seems that any value we try and give it, it just doesn't seem to fit with our division rule with infinity. In this interesting system, we can divide by 0 with no issues. But when 0 is multiplied by infinity, we must now leave this as undefined. But there is a system where it does work. A system where you can divide 0 by 0, and more importantly, all the usual math rules fit perfectly. But I have to admit, it's not a very big space. In fact, it's downright tiny. For this last number system, imagine a space where we only have a single point. And let's call this point 0. We have all of the usual operations, but since we only have one point to deal with, the answer is always the same. 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 multiplied by 0 is 0. And 0 divided by 0 is 0. Since this is the only point we could ever use, and the only answer we could ever get, it fits perfectly with all of the usual math rules. 0 divided by 0 doesn't cause any problems. That's because the multiplication problem, 0 is equal to 0 times 0, is really the only one we have to consider. This system simply doesn't have any non-zero elements to cause any problems. The unfortunate part about this system is that it's not big enough to do any interesting problems with. We can define bizarre operations all day long, but if the only value we can ever get is 0, then we're not really getting any new information. This is truly unfortunate, since the power behind math is in its ability to give us new insights. And in this particular space, there's nothing left to see. Don't worry, all is not lost. By working really hard to find a space where we can actually divide by 0, we've gained more understanding about the number system we use every day. With this in mind, I hope you can see why it really is best to leave 0 divided by 0 as undefined. It leaves us with a number system that is definitely large enough for interesting problems, but also leaves us with a system that has the rules needed for modeling the world around us. Thanks for watching. Did you enjoy watching this video? Don't forget to hit the like button and then subscribe to my channel. As always, you can find all of my videos free of charge at MySecretMathTutor.com. Again, thanks for watching.